What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create your own custom material library in V-Ray for SketchUp. Let's get started. Remember to watch until the end of this video so I can show you where to download some of my materials for free. Now, let's get into the video. First, if you don't know how to create individual materials, then watch this video. This video will show you how to take different texture maps, such as diffuse, normal, bump, reflection, displacement, etc., and put them in the correct slots in V-Ray to create a realistic material. After you've learned how to correctly create a material, then you can save that material by right-clicking and save as, or using this button here. When you save a material like this, it will give you a VRMat file and a maps folder with all of the texture maps that you've used for that material. So when you want to use this material in another project, you can simply load it using this button here. When it's loaded, every maps will be applied to the right texture slots, so the material is ready for render right away. But of course, you can always go back and adjust the material even more if you need. There we go, now you can repeat this process to create your own library of V-Ray materials. When doing this, it's a good idea to keep your materials organized by categories, similar to what I did here. As you can see, I just repeat this method to create my own material library. When you have created a library, instead of loading in multiple VRMat files every time you work on a model, you can actually save them inside of the V-Ray material library so that you have access to it every time you open up the asset editor. To do this in V-Ray 3.4 and 3.6, you need to copy the VRMat files and texture maps, then place them in the appropriate folder. This is the folder path for V-Ray 3.4, and this is the path for V-Ray 3.6. Just copy and paste your materials there. After you've done that, just restart SketchUp and open up the asset editor, then go to the materials library, and you should be able to see your materials there. And since I have a folder for each category, you can see that my materials have been very well organized. Pretty cool, huh? For V-Ray next, there's a better way to do this. By using this button here, you can add a custom folder location. After it's loaded, you will be able to see your collection of materials like so. Now you can add any material to your scene by simply dragging it in here, or you can also right-click and select Add to Scene. You can search for materials here as well. The cool thing about V-Ray next is that you can easily save new materials by dragging it in the folder like this. Or if you make edits to a material, then you can just drag it back into its folder to update it. If the preview is not updated, then just click the folder and refresh it. And there we go, that's a quick video showing you how to create your own material library in V-Ray for SketchUp. If you want to get some free materials, then you can go to my website using this link here. For every material, I've made a 1K and a 4K version. The 1K resolution version is completely free, but the 4K is only available for my members on Patreon. If that's something you're interested in, you can join my Patreon and get the whole material library with just one click. I update this material library monthly too, so you will get new materials every month. I also want to thank all of my members on Patreon who have been supporting me. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.